shots and goals, rock the shows, big bang rolls, cash. Now she go, go for the team, now she don't ski, splash. Think about post not on the ground, man, delete her. Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers. Think about post not on the ground, man, delete her. Whole gang in the field, we don't do bleachers.
Woke up and I'm feeling like a boss right now. I woke up and I'm feeling like a boss right now. I'm gonna hold it down, I swear. I roll up and I'm smelling like a boss right now. I do this for my rounds, oh yeah. Dripping in the sauce right now. Get a sprinkle of my style. I'm about to lock down.
Feel like in the real life, dripping on sauce in a good life. You shine, I shine, and ain't nobody gonna take my love. I just wanna be a boss. I will never ever fall.
I feel like a boss right now. Talk to the man.
I swear my life is amazing. Blowing money, no hesitation. There's no basis. I know they be hating, but that's what made me
feel like in the real life, dripping on sauce in a good life. You shine, I shine, and ain't nobody gonna take my.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Dallas Cowboys. The kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. Ezekiel Elliott gonna take it the distance. 20. Touchdown. touchdown, Cowboys! Ezekiel Elliott, 75 yards, and the Cowboys have taken the early lead. The very first play from scrimmage, how about that? Talk about setting a tone.
And people always talk about doing exactly that in the first 5 minutes of the game, the first offensive and defensive series, who's going to gain an advantage? But we saw exactly what happened there. A tone was definitely set by the offensive team.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 21. The first carry now, this is Alvin Kamara. And the window closes quickly. He'll only get up to the 22-yard line. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Here we go.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now Breeze. And the Cowboys' pressure gets there this time for the sack. David Irving able to swap him from that defensive tackle spot for a loss of 5. Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. From the gun, it's Breeze. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just...
And they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. And this is caught. And now this is going to be close. The defense says they stopped him, and they did. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
Anytime a fake doesn't work, we usually focus our attention on the guys that were unsuccessful. But how about the defensive guys? They have to plan all week. They have to prepare all week. Special teams, it looked like they were educated for that one.
Educated on their toes and getting a big stop. Tackle there by Alex Anzalone.
46.
Second down, Prescott. Flushed out right. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. He'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. Third and short yardage, Prescott. He dropped it. Couldn't hang on in the end zone. So no 6 points, incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. Prescott down. And they hit him as he throws, as this one's going to go straight down to the turf. Incomplete. Jason Garrett might be wanting to reconsider the decision to go for it there. And the Saints will have the football back. So Bree's going to lead the Saints up here, first and 10 at their own 21. They start the drive on the ground. Kamara. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game. So what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Breeze on the draw, gives to Kamara. And a short pickup there as he'll take this up to right around the 20. Give him 2 yards that time, and it's going to leave him with a third and 11 situation. shotgun now for Breeze. Flush to his right. Now he'll let it go deep right. And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this down deep on the Cowboys' side of the field. A big play. Breeze finding Thomas. 64 yards. So from their own 20 all the way to the red zone now. A chance to capitalize on first and 10. Into the red zone. It's Breeze. He hits his target. Left side, Watson. And here he'll get it down to the 7. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is. And they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Just a gain of a yard, but it's going to set him up with a first and goal. Kamara. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. Give him 4 on the carry there. It's 2nd and goal. When we talk about being on schedule, I think they're on schedule after that run, getting it right down there on the doorstep.
Maybe even a little bit ahead, because now the defense can't dictate with pressure. They're guessing about where you're going to go. I might come right back at them with the same play, the same set, and see if they can stop them.
And just one man in the backfield here. That's Kamara, 2nd and goal. They get it to him running left. And this one will wind up with him losing yardage. Back to the 4-yard line. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
They'll try to run it in. It's Kamara. And he'll get it down close to the goal line, but not quite in. This defense bending but not breaking. It's a gain of 3. It's now 4th and goal. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on 4th down. They're running. Ingram. And he's not even going to come close to picking up the first. They stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Ingram denied on 4th and goal. And this Cowboy defense comes up with a goal line stand. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. They'll start the drive with Elliott. And an alley to run. Ezekiel Elliott gonna take it the distance. He's at the 40. Past the 20. 10. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott, 99 yards. And the Cowboys are able to show off their quick strike ability. Extra point splits the uprights. And that'll make the score 14-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything. At least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. Earlier this half, you were wondering how the defense was going to handle him defensively. Were they going to bottle him up at different levels, so to speak, is what you said. What have you seen so far?
Well, I think they've been absolutely terrific because it feels like on every play, if we were watching this in the film room, when they clicked off the film or stopped it, you would see 11 shirts of that same color right there in the frame trying to tackle him. That's what you're looking for.
Breeze now on first down. Bryant with a catch right side. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks. 2 minutes to play here in the first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. First down is Breeze. And Watson has it right side. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And a nice gain of 21 yards. On first and 10, here's Breeze. And he will go down. A Cowboys sack. DeMarcus Lawrence. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
Here we go.
Now they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21.
Four down. Ready. You ready?
Working from the gun, it's Breeze. Trying here for Bryant, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. But while we have a second here, how about we get bold and make a couple Super Bowl predictions?
Hey, why not? Let's go ahead and put ourselves on the spot.
Just more fodder for the angry people. What do you think? Who's going to win it? Who's going to be the MVP?
Well, my prediction for this one is the New England Patriots win the football game. They win it 32-30. The MVP, the McCourty twins. Jason and Devin, they both get 2 interceptions apiece, and instead of splitting the trophy, they wrestle for it right there on the 50-yard line post-game, because you know sibling rivalries, one always wants the upper hand.
Okay, that's bold. I'll go Rams on a Greg Zuerlein 44-yarder from the right hash as time expires.
44?
MVP,
that's nothing for
Todd,
him.
MVP Todd Gurley, 2 touchdowns, 1 catching, 1 rushing.
I like it.
You don't like
the McCourty thing, though.
No, I do like that. If that happens, you're Nostradamus.
There you go.
They play faked Elliott. Now Prescott sliding out of the pocket. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. And now the Saints are going to take a timeout on defense. As the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in half number one. They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long.
Here we go, 46.
Prescott from the gun. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And they pick up 25 as they convert on third.
I think it all came together there. In breaking route, drove it with excellent pace. Money throw right there to move the sticks.
And the Saints signal for another timeout as they get it right at the 32nd mark of this first half.
47. Under.
A first down carry by Elliott. Eventually wrangled down before reaching the 20, but a strong run. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. As they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Prescott now on second down. Had his hands on it, but dropped it. The rookie making a little bit of a rookie mistake, third down.
Right up to that point, I was about to say he's had a pretty good half catching the football, but let's just be honest about it. He should have caught that one.
And he knows that. That was one right in his breadbasket and one he normally catches.
Prescott from the gun on third. Throw right side, taken in by Gallup. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. First opportunity in the red zone for the Cowboys. They've got a first and 10 at the 17. From the red zone now, Prescott. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Von Bell. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Likely time for one final snap as they start out first and 10.
Four down, four, ready. Yellow lady, yellow lady.
They begin on the ground with Kamara. And he's going to lose yardage here. Back to his own 18. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters. Well, that came a little abruptly here. Still working on my apple up in the booth. Hang on here. Let me spit this out. And we can get to the third quarter now. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there, because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they feel like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out. So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Under.
On first down, Breeze. Out left side here to Bryant. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Breeze gonna throw. He's gonna loft one deep left side here. And that's caught inside the 30. A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
You know I'm going to lean towards the defender, right? You know I'm going to do that.
I know.
That's a tough situation for him, as I see it. But the truth of the matter is, that ball was not streaking towards him. Had a little arc on it. He's got to find a way to get his head around and make a play on the football.
Breeze now on first down. Caught on the left side by Ginn. Great move, but still wrangled before reaching the 20. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Ready. Ready.
Again, they'll throw with Breeze. Drops this off to Kamara out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll lead here to a third down.
Got four. Ready. Ready.
Breeze to throw again. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth.
Ready? You ready?
They'll go for it. It's Breeze. And he's going to have his running back. It's complete. Some collective exhales over there on the sideline. A big pickup through the air on fourth down to bring up first and goal. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. A 10th carry for Kamara. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. Defensively, it was Leighton Vander Esch up from his linebacker spot. Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's second and 11. They'll give it to him up the middle. And able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four. 7 big yards on the carry there to get him within range of the goal line with third down upcoming. Throw. And he fires one, but incomplete.
So typically you'd say nice job defensively to force a decision on fourth down, but they've already gone for it once and converted, so you better make sure your defense stays out on the field and is alert.
On fourth down, off goes Drew Brees, and on comes the Saints kicker Will Lutz for the field goal attempt. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's the Saints who hold the football, but they're trailing as we begin the fourth quarter of play. Lutz now to kick this one away. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Here we go, 46. Here we go, 48. 41 for Will.
They start on the ground with Elliott. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, Brandon Pace comes into play now because they've got the advantage. They've got the football, but they've got to be very careful about what speed they're going to play. You know, my music teacher back in New Paltz, Mrs. Bythema Bagley, used to say, don't go prestissimo when you really want to go largo. And what she meant by that is don't go too fast when you really want to go at a nice, slow, deliberate pace.
I am speechless. I am without speech. Prescott. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Picked off by the linebacker, Demario Davis. And his crew will take over with a football at the 35-yard line. Cooper was the target there. 2-score game here in the fourth, and that pick, it kind of keeps the door ajar, doesn't it?
It does, and you wonder about their strategy because with a 2-score lead, you would think maybe you're just sitting on and trying to drain some clock. It's almost like they felt like, hey, we've got a good cushion. We can keep pressing it. It ended up costing him.
He's going to flip that out to the flat. It's complete, and he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line. It's a gain of 9 yards, and that'll make it 2nd and short. From the gun, it's Breeze. He throws it, he hits the slant right to Thomas. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. A good pickup there, a 22.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch, but you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
He'll get it up the middle. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air. They may be snapping a ball near the goal line, but all you're thinking defensively, keep them out of the end zone. Force the incompletion, force them into going for 3 and not giving up 6. Here we go.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, 3rd and goal. Now Breeze. This is caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. A great play there from 4 yards out. And the Saints are back within a score. They're going to try and run, but he will not get in here. He stopped up short of the goal line, and this will remain a 5-point game. Lutz now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. Right now clinging to a 1-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that 4-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you are a little bit more careful about what you're calling. You want plays, they're going to gain yardage. How would you say it? Consistently, right? You don't need the big shots downfield, but make sure the clock continues to run. Pile up the first down. And the goal? End the game with your quarterback kneeling down at the end, and you still have the lead.
It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets them to 2nd and 4. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. A good pickup there, a 22. Defensively, they're okay with that. Short little route, tackle him inbounds. Okay.
All right, cliche alert. It's time for someone to make a play because they've got to have something bigger downfield. They can't just take what they give them. They've got to force it and make something big happen for them.
The give is to Elliott. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. And the Saints signal for another timeout. That's going to be their 2nd. They'll be left with 1 more plus the 2-minute warning, and we'll be back. Here's Prescott. To the right side, he's got Cooper. It's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Well, probably the only thing he did wrong there was go out of bounds, nursing this 4th-quarter lead. You want to stay in, eat the clock.
Yeah, you got to love the effort, the catch, the extra yardage, but you've got to know the situation. Stay in bounds, young man.
Again to Elliott. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. And now here comes the 3rd of their timeouts defensively. So they'll be left with only the 2-minute warning to stop it from here on out. On 2nd down, Elliott trying to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. A.J. Klein on the tackle there. Hey, time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. 10th carry now for Elliott. And certainly some style points there on the spin. Not a whole lot thereafter, but still a pretty good gain. They'll get six there on the run, but it brings up fourth down. So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. From the left hash, this from 34. And his kick here is good. And high fives for that one as that drive ends in three. Now from a defensive perspective, though, I think maybe they're saying, hey, we did what we needed to do, kept this a one-score game.
Yeah, without a doubt, because they were able to bleed some time off the clock, right? Put themselves in a good position, but it's not out of reach yet, okay? Being able to hold them to a field goal means that they do have a chance to come back and win this game.
Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They're down here in a one-score game. But the time, it's a factor, but it's not a huge factor right now, is it?
It's really not, because this amount of time gives them a chance to run their offense, to go through play sequences. And this is what they work on every week in practice, usually on a Friday. They go over this type of a situation, late-game situation. What are we going to do when we have the opportunity? They've called these plays a bunch of times. Now's their chance to execute them.
And they have the opportunity now. Here's the execution. And he'll be hit as he releases it. And that'll fall incomplete. He couldn't get the hook up there that time with Thomas. And now it's second down. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28.
Got it. 21. Got it.
Back to throw. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So back-to-back incompletions now, third and 10. And first things first, before you think about marching the ball down the field, you got to move the chains.
You're exactly right. Got to get back into focus here. Get the first down. That's what's vital to them.
Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
They'll look to throw. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. It's picked up by the Cowboys. And to the 43. So down inside the 45 to the 43-yard line. That's where they'll take over. The Cowboys on their way to victory as they take a knee. Down to a knee one more time, and that should just about do it.
Yeah, it's fun to kneel down in front of your home crowd, but when you go on the road, that band of brothers attitude, right, just us against the world, and get it done, how happy are they?
I remember a coach at a previous stop tell me, you get a win on the road, doesn't matter the opponent, get out of there like you stole something, and they did in this one. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never